In this video, we're going to learn about dot products, projections, and components. Now, the definition of a dot product is pretty straightforward. You take two vectors, and you define the dot product of the two vectors, column u and v, to be the length of the first vector times the length of the second vector times the cosine of the angle between them. Now, it's a pretty simple formula, but you might think, where the heck did that come from? Why do we care about the cosine? Why not cosine squared, or secant, or tangent, or sine, or some other function? Why do we use the cosine? And the reason for this, in fact, the reason for most of calculus, comes from physics. In physics, there's a notion of work. If something is moving, and you push it in the direction of motion, you make it go faster. So you got a car rolling along from left to right, and somebody pushes it, and it goes faster, and as it goes faster, it gets more and more kinetic energy, and we call the extra kinetic energy that you give it work. And the formula for work is it's the force times the distance. In this case, the work is positive because the force is to the right, and the motion is to the right. So if we're just measuring things left to right, it's a positive force times a positive distance. That's positive. On the other hand, if you put a force that's going against the direction of motion, if you're moving right to left, and somebody is pushing left to right, you're slowing the car down. In this case, the work is the force times the distance. The force is positive. The distance is negative because you're going right to left. And the product of the two is negative. Now that would be the end of the story if we lived in a one-dimensional world. But of course we don't. If you've ever been on a roller coaster, you know that as you move along the roller coaster, you go in lots of different directions. You're always going a little bit sideways, but you go down and up and level off. And whenever you're heading downhill, no matter how much you're going side to side, as you go downhill, you speed up. And as you go uphill, you slow down. And as you go on a flat stretch, you neither speed up nor slow down. The gravity doesn't really have much of an effect on you. So we need more than just force times distance because, you know, from here to here, there's a certain distance. And from here to here, there's a distance. And from here to here, there's a distance. And from here to here, there's a distance. But the distance isn't enough. We have to keep track of the direction as well. What we really care about isn't how much you go side to side, but only how much you go up and down. For this part, you're going downhill. You're moving. You've got a net motion in the direction of the force, and so you speed up. In this part, you have a negative net motion in the direction of the force. You're going uphill while the force is downhill, and you slow down. In this part, you're moving horizontally. You have no motion in the direction of the force, and you neither speed up nor slow down. So the work isn't the force times the distance. It's the force times the amount of distance in the direction of the force. Motion that's perpendicular to the force just doesn't count. Now we can express this mathematically. Mathematically, if you take two vectors, let's call them v and u, and they have an angle theta between them, you can say, let's look at a new vector, let's call it w. And w is the part of v that's pointing in the u direction. There's also a part of v that's pointing in perpendicular to u. We don't care about that. We only want the part of v that's pointing in the u direction. And the size of that, the amount of that it's pointing in the u direction, well, we know that this length is this length times the cosine of theta. So the amount of v in the u direction is v cosine theta. We give this a name. We call this the component of v in the u direction. And the notation is comp u in the v direction. We also call it the scalar projection of v onto u. So you'll hear both terms, scalar projection and component, and they mean the same thing. And so our formula for the dot product is we wanted u times v times cosine theta. That's the length of u times the length of the component of u in the v direction. Component of v in the u direction. So for force dotted into distance, for our work, we say our work should be not force times distance. Force and distance are both vectors. It's force dotted into distance, which is the size of the force times the amount of distance that's in the direction of the force. And so that gives you the length of u times the length of v times the cosine of the angle between them. And the nice thing about that is that if you swap the roles of v and u, you get the exact same thing. And so u dot v and v dot u is the same thing. When you figure out work, you can either say, we only care about motion in the direction of the force, or we can say, we only care about the amount of force in the direction of the motion. It's the amount that these two things tend to go together that is the dot product. Now, I talked about this vector w. It has a name itself. It's called the vector projection of v onto u. And the notation for that is proj u of v. So proj u of v is vector projection. Comp u of v is scalar projection or component. And of course, the length of w in this picture is the component. Now, it's not always a component. Sometimes it's minus a component. If v is pointing away from u, then the component will be negative, but of course the length of w will still be positive. So in general, you have plus or minus, but if you're pointing in the u direction, it's positive. And so if you want to have a formula for w, you just take the length of w times the direction of w. The direction of w is u divided by the length of u. And there's a simple formula for this. It's just u dot v over u squared times u. And the length of u squared is the same thing as u dotted into u. So once we learn how to compute dot products algebraically, these dot products will be really easy to compute and we'll be able to come up with projections from this simple formula. So to sum up, the component, or the scalar projection, is v cosine theta, and you get that by taking the dot product and dividing by the length of u. The projection is the portion of the v vector that's in the u direction, and this is the vector projection, and we write proj u for it. And the length of proj u is plus or minus comp u. And the dot product can be written in terms of either the component of u in the v in the u direction or the component of u in the v direction, or just as u v cosine theta.